Charitable giving and volunteering may look a whole lot different this holiday season, with millions more people struggling because of the pandemic. The San Diego Selection section of the Meals on Wheels has seen a 50% increase of older residents receiving home-delivered meals and other services. Joining us now to talk more about it is the president and the CEO of San Diego Meals on Wheels, Brent Wakefield. Hi, Brent. How are you?
Great, Logan. Thanks so much for having us.
Great to see you. Tell us what Meals on Wheels is doing for this week as we move into the holiday season.
Well, right now we're really ramping up. You know, we have, as you said, about a 50% increase in our clientele. So we're working hard with our volunteers to make sure that all the routes are covered, that we don't only deliver a hot meal, but the seniors also get a warm smile when our volunteers show up. And that's a really important and critical part of what we're doing. Because right now we're really keyed in on combating the loneliness and the isolation that's going on right now during the holiday seasons. I mean, as you mentioned, kind of in the beginning of your service, we've got this horrible outbreak. Seniors now more than ever are really asked to stay safe and stay at home. And so what we can do with our volunteers is safely deliver a meal, but have that interaction. And if they seem to be too depressed as well, our volunteers are working on a program called Companionship Calls. So they can actually call a senior that they've paired with once or twice a week and have a 30 or 60 minute conversation just about life and anything, just to stay connected. So we're about feeding the seniors and staying connected. And right now, as we kind of move towards that Giving Tuesday, really a shout out to our volunteers and asking more people to sign up and join.
Boy, what a difficult situation. You talk about how seniors really like having that person come to the door. They can socialize. They can kind of chit chat a little bit. And now you've got COVID-19. You're supposed to keep your distance. Everybody's wearing a mask. How do they continue to kind of get a connection with those people and still stay within those parameters?
Yeah, you know, the business model is kind of the same, but you know, what you're alluding to is different, is the seniors, they open the door and we'll have the meal sitting there somewhere next to the door. We've, you know, show up and knock on the door and our volunteers have a mask on. And then they step back, you know, probably about 10 feet, and they have a conversation with Mr. Jones or Mrs. Smith and check in with them. And if they notice that anything is a little bit off, maybe they're confused or whatever, on the app that they're using to deliver the meal, they can actually indicate that, push a button. It alerts our care coordinators, and then we activate somebody to get out there and check up on them. But we still have that interaction with them. We don't cross the threshold like we used to, because it's not safe right now, and we can't wait to get back to that model. But for the time being, from 6 to 10 feet, we're having good conversations and really establishing that connection that's keeping them from really feeling alone.
I know you're always looking for volunteers, whether it's somebody who drives the meals to people who need them, or I understand now you can actually volunteer from home and maybe try to make a connection.
Absolutely. We would love to get people involved in our companionship call program. And that's a lot of fun. You get to call up a senior, you get paired with them and, you know, have a conversation, check in with them. And, you know, a lot of them will like to talk about their past, but also the favorite things about the holidays, what they're doing. It might even be politics, but they just need to share their ideas and have that connection. You know, we know that children, the developing mind, really need interaction for that development to happen. And we also know, and we witness this with our grandparents, that the aging mind also really requires a lot of social interaction to stay vibrant and to stay connected and to combat depression. And so that's what these opportunities like the companionship call are really all about.
We talked about 50% more older residents receiving these home-delivered meals now. Why do you think that is? Are we just growing? Are we living longer? Does the pandemic have something to do with it?
Yeah, that 50% increase happened in about 3 weeks' time at the beginning of the pandemic, and we've sustained that. So I think that is largely due to the pandemic. But you're right. I mean, every day in America right now, you look at the baby boomers, there are about 10,000 people that are turning 65. And so in our county right now, we have a huge chunk of people, about 600,000, that are over the age of 65. That's a massive population in our county. So it's an important population to connect with. Now, of that group, we are delivering meals to 2,000 individual seniors every day to their doorstep and having an interaction. But there are a lot more out there that could use our services for sure.
And if somebody wants more information, should they just go to your website?
Yeah, we would really like them to do, everything is there. We've made it kind of a one-stop shop for folks. So it's meals-on-wheels.org. You go to that website and you'll get all the information that you need. And we're only a phone call away if anybody has special questions as well. And also sometimes it's about helping a neighbor, an aunt, an uncle, a mother, or father. So you can find that information there as well. And we'll help you help your senior neighbors and friends.
Brent Wakefield, good to talk to you, Brent. We'll put that information on our website as well.
Thank you, Logan. I appreciate the opportunity. I hope you all have a safe holiday. Stay well.
All right. You do the same. Thanks so
Thank
much.
You. All right. Thanks. Bye-bye.